Back, and as you can see, I am in my apartment and I'm here in Florida, and I had a really fun time coming down. I was on a road trip with my mom, and I had a lot of fun saying goodbye to my friends, even though it was really hard, and my family before I left to come here. And so yeah, Florida's been pretty good. Like, it's very different from California. To be honest, I like the weather a lot better. And before I show you a montage of my last couple days before my trip, I would like to tell you guys a little bit later after the montage about check-in and casting. And so then I've been sick, and as you can tell, I'm losing my voice, or my voice was more gone before, so that's why I didn't upload more. But I will do my best to catch you guys all up on all the info. So, without further ado, here is a montage of my last couple days and some of my road trip with my mom on my way here.
Come true.
Cities during my road trip. I went through, I believe, New Mexico, Arizona, Texas. I went through Mississippi and Louisiana. We were going to stop at New Orleans, but when I got to New Orleans, I got really sick and I completely lost my voice. I was coughing, and yeah, one of my friends was sick before I left, so I think I got it from her, but it's okay. It was worth it because I wanted to see her. I would like to explain some of the things that happened when I got here on my first day. So, me and my mom arrived a day earlier, and we stayed at the Holiday Inn, and so we had a day to kind of like prepare what we were going to do. And so the morning of, we packed up our car from the Holiday Inn, and funny thing is, one of my roommates, Callie, was actually staying at the Holiday Inn that I was staying at, and yeah, I thought that was really cool. I wanted to meet up with her, but I was just like really tired and I wanted to get some rest before like all this madness started. But so on the first day of check-in, me and my mom pulled into, there's a security gate, and I just had to tell them that I was there to check in that morning for the Disney College program. And so they were letting in the guests to help them drop them off. And also, I don't know if it had a difference or anything, but I was with my mom, and my cousin had registered her car the day before because she had already been here. So we were driving her car, and we met up with her previously to let her register her car for the program. So I don't know if it was a difference, if it just let you in because someone was dropping you off. But she already had her car registered for like the complexes. So I'm not sure if that made a difference or not. But yeah, so they let us to the gate. And however, parents and people who weren't in the program could not come in to check in with you, so that is very important to know. And it's very important to know that. So you have to have your ID and your arrival itinerary printed out with you, and your dorms pass. Be sure you have those. Those are very, very important. And just make sure you brought all of your documentation too for your I-9, because that came in handy for casting, for your casting appointment as well. I got to the clubhouse at my dorm, and or not dorm, apartment, and I'm living in Vista Way, actually. I don't think I ever revealed my location or my complex. So, surprise everyone, my location is Magic Kingdom, and I'm really excited about it because it's like kind of like a nod to home, where I'm from. And I don't know how similar it is to Disneyland, but I might actually do a video with one of my roommates that is living with me, and we were talking about, well, maybe like she's like saying the myths she heard about Disneyland, and I could debunk them, and it'd be kind of like a collaborative video. So I think that'd be kind of a cool idea for a video. But anyway, yeah, I get to the clubhouse, and they ask for my identification. I show them and my arrival itinerary, and so then they give me a book and my key. I went inside, and they gave me this program guide, and this is a very important guide because it tells you a bunch of details about like basically everything about your housing and safety and everything important in here. And then on the other side, I'm gonna cover this so you don't see my actual address, but it gives you your name, your address, and what apartment you have, like how many people are in your apartment with you, and and it tells the date that your check-in was, and then like attached to it right here was a key to your apartment. So luckily, like, I was the very first one, and the good thing is that like they gave me this, and it's like a thing for your ID. I have a housing ID, and they take your picture like on check-in day too, and they print out your housing ID, and this is very, very important to have with you everywhere you go. It is like basically your ticket into your apartment complex, and they also provide you with a lanyard, and it's really helpful because I did not have one, but I eventually do want to get a Disney one. And yeah, so I had the key, and I was the first one to check in out of all my roommates. So my mom was able to come into the complex to help me move into my apartment. And surprisingly, I thought I had more stuff than I actually did. My mom was able to help me move into my apartment, which was really helpful. And so we unpacked everything, and we basically left the apartment afterwards to go shopping for everything we needed. We went to Target, TJ Maxx, Walmart. It's all pretty close to here, which was nice. Yeah, so anyway, so that was check-in. And then casting, we just did a bunch of paperwork. They got your fingerprints and got all your documentation, and they took your picture for the blue ID, so be prepared for that. And you had to show your documentation to a recruiter. And somehow I was lucky enough to get Kirk. And he was just like the sweetest guy. He was so fun to talk to. We were talking about Broadway and Dear Evan Hansen. And he told me the one thing he gets excited about is either Native American IDs or birth abroad birth certificates. And the funny thing is that I had originally given him my social security card. And he told me that, and I was like, well, you know, I was born abroad. Like, I was born in Germany. I have a birth certificate. Do you want to use it? And he's like, oh my gosh, yes, you just made my day. And so, like, when he told me that I made his day, I was like, you're like a celebrity to me, and I just made your day. That is so cool. But yeah, that was really fun. And then, yeah, and then like, so we had, that day was very busy. And then the next, like, I think it was the next day. Yeah. Or was it the next day? No. I think it might have been the same day. Yeah, it was the same day. It was actually yesterday. Me and my roommates went to the Polynesian because my roommate and friend Olivia had her 21st birthday, and we celebrated there, and we watched the Happily Ever After fireworks from the Polynesian Beach, and it was so beautiful, and I loved it so much, and I actually have a little bit of footage from it, and so here's some of the footage, and then I'll tell you my reaction because it was kind of funny. So there we go. So yeah, that was my reaction, and I was like screaming and just like, I screamed as much as I could. Can't really scream because my voice is gone, but I was really excited because they were playing a lot of the songs that, of the Disney movies that don't get a lot of credit, like Hercules, and they were playing Tarzan and Hunchback of Notre Dame, and I always am like, those movies never get enough credit, and like Disney World like made my day because they used all the songs. But yeah, so it was really exciting, and then we got drinks afterwards. So Yeah, and she's 21 now, so it was really fun. And then today I had costume fitting. I can't really say a lot of details about that because I am in entertainment and there is a thing called character integrity, and it just helps keep the magic alive. So I am unable to explain what happens during that process as well, but it was just a very interesting experience, and I felt like a dork, but it was really, really fun. So, yeah, that's pretty much it, and this is my Vista Bay. We decorated it all pretty, and like this is the fridge behind me. Olivia and her parents helped decorate the living room, and it is literally beautiful, and I will do an apartment tour sometime when everything's like more settled in. You would sit and talk to me for hours when I'm lonely in a world of my own. There'd be new bands, lots of nice and friendly howdy-do bands. Everyone would have a dozen bluebirds.